Well, since you clicked on this video, I have a feeling that you enjoy new archaeological discoveries or ancient history as a whole. Maybe you want to know more about human evolution or ancient stone structures. And if any of that is the case, then I highly suggest you subscribe to the channel, click that bell icon to be notified whenever I upload. And if you enjoy my work, maybe consider becoming a patron or a channel member. So, we know that ancient humans have been living on the British Isles for approximately 800,000 years due to the discovered footprints at Hasbro on the East Coast. But just because we know that they've been there doesn't mean that they were actually like living there full time. So there's little to no evidence of occupation besides the footprints that date this far back. And thankfully, as we all know, new discoveries are being made all the time, quite often actually, and now we actually have conclusive evidence of occupation on the outskirts of Canterbury in Kent. But before I go into the rest of this video, I would like to mention that this particular video is kindly sponsored by CyberGhost. And as always, more on that later in the video. So my name is Kaylee, and in this video I'm going to tell you all about this latest discovery made near Canterbury that showed that ancient humans lived in that area some 600,000 years ago. It's actually quite the amazing find because this is one of the earliest known Paleolithic sites in the entirety of Northern Europe. So first, as always, you know how I like to conduct my research and how I write my videos, we're going to look at the location of the discovery because it's important to know where a discovery has been made and how that connects to the bigger picture. So this Paleolithic site is located in an ancient riverbed near a town named Fordwich, which is also the name of the civil parish, and it's located just 2 miles northeast of the city of Canterbury in the county of Kent, which is situated on the east coast in the south of England. That's quite the location. I mean, I pinpointed that perfectly. Fordwich is actually, and this is a fun fact, it's the smallest community by population in Britain that has a town council. I do enjoy throwing in small fun facts like this. So this Paleolithic site was first discovered in 1920, and this was when local laborers discovered ancient tools like hand axes, but it wasn't known how old the site was or how old these tools were. And honestly, this entire site has been quite overlooked for the next 90 years, up until recently. So recently there have been new excavations at this site. Around 2020 they started, and new techniques were used to date the discovered artifacts. And when I say artifacts, I mean the artifacts that were discovered in the 1920s and the newly discovered artifacts from the latest excavations. So what techniques did the researchers actually use to date these artifacts? So the stone tools were dated using infrared radiofluorescence dating, or in short IRRF, which is a technique that can determine the point in time when feldspar sand grains were last exposed to sunlight. And therefore they can pinpoint the moment in which these artifacts got buried. So using this dating method, they discovered that the oldest of these tools were buried between 560,000 and 620,000 years ago. Quite a long time ago, actually. But before I go and tell you which species of ancient human are most likely to credit for the creation of these tools and the occupation of this site, I would like to tell you a bit about today's sponsor. So I wonder, are you feeling unprotected when you're using public networks? Do you want to feel safe, but not at the cost of the speed and the responsiveness? Well, look no further. With CyberGhost VPN, your digital security will jump to the next level. Connecting to the internet through a virtual private network, or otherwise known VPN, empowers you to stay protected while you're online. CyberGhost VPN transmits your data through a secure, encrypted tunnel, giving you a high level of online anonymity and high-grade security. With more than 38 million users and a 5-star rating at Trustpilot, reviewed by over 14,000 users, and a price of just $2.23 per month, plus 4 months for free, it's simply one of the best VPN service providers that helps you and your data stay protected. Experience online freedom with restrictions on up to 7 devices simultaneously, and share it with your family and your friends to overcome blocked online content, whether that's a website or social media platform or a streaming service with your favorite history documentary. CyberGhost VPN supports an incredible 40 streaming services. So click the link in the description down below to get this awesome offer that is available only for my subscribers. So what are you waiting for? And now it's time to look into which ancient human species lived at this location. So when looking at the evolutionary timeline and which ancient humans occupied this area, we can conclude that it's most likely Homo Heidelbergensis that lived at this Paleolithic site. So, as I mentioned before, this is not the oldest evidence of humans being present in Britain, as the footprints at Hasbro are between 950,000 and 840,000 years old, and these prints were most likely made by the first ancient human to ever occupy Europe, which was Homo antecessor, which I covered in a video a while ago, and I highly recommend checking that video out because not many of you actually did, and that's a shame. And yes, I'm also planning to make a video on Homo heidelbergensis. I started the script even a while ago, but I enjoy taking my time to create videos like that and take the time to research, and I haven't had the time yet. So it may take a bit before that comes out. And like I mentioned earlier, in the 1920s, ancient hand axes were discovered at this Acheulean site, and these date back to between 560,000 and 620,000 years ago. But in the new excavations that were carried out in 2020, a lot more tools were discovered, tools like cores and flakes, retouched tools and scrapers, but they also found tools with piercing implements. So what we know about Homo heidelbergensis is that it was a hunter-gatherer species, which isn't that weird, but you know, everyone back then was hunter-gatherer, but whatever. They were known to eat a variety of animals and plants, and many of these tools actually could have been used to process these animal remains and these plant remains for food, but the tools with the piercing implements could have been used for different activities. So the scrapers and these piercing implements could suggest that Homo heidelbergensis at this location were preparing animal hides, probably for the creation of shelters and clothing. It's Britain, it's wet. Even back then, I bet it was wet and cold. So yeah, you need clothes. So while the hand axes may not be the oldest hand axes ever found in Britain, the cores, the scrapers and the flakes, and even the retouched pieces are the oldest ever found in Britain up until this point in time. That's amazing. So this does show the technological diversity of the ancient humans, the Homo heidelbergensis species, occupying this area. And that in itself is of importance when looking at this time period. Some of the tools that were discovered here seem to be unusually small, and that in itself is very rare among the Lower Paleolithic in Northern Europe, but further excavations will have to be carried out to uncover the prevalence of these artifacts. For a long time, ancient humans have been living in Northern Europe, although most evidence pointed to a very nomadic lifestyle of short occupation per location. I enjoy that sentence. And this Paleolithic site shows that Homo heidelbergensis occupied the area for quite a long time, actually. Although this could have been an intermittent type of occupation. And actually, this Paleolithic site is now being considered to be among the most important sites of the Acheulean period in Northwest Europe. And that's incredible because it was overlooked for 90 years. am I glad that they started excavating there. The discoveries made here actually suggest that the ancient humans living in this area around this time weren't just simply surviving, but they were most likely actually thriving. And that in itself is amazing. And do remember that Britain at this time was not the island that we see today. Britain back then was connected with mainland Europe through the landmass known as Doggerland. Doggerland. That I created a very, very in-depth video about back in August 2021. Highly suggest watching that as well if you haven't. I put a lot of work and effort into that, and yeah, it's a mini documentary. Maybe you have seen it, but the details of it have become a bit blurry because it's been a while and might as well watch it again. Doggerland is of great significance in this puzzle that is the timeline of ancient humans in Europe. Our evolution, Doggerland, took a lot of puzzle pieces with it when it went down underwater. I will create more videos on Doggerland in the future as well, because there's so much to discuss. There's so much to cover and to uncover at this point in time. And I hope that they will still investigate the area more as time goes by. And thankfully, the archaeologists are planning more excavations here at Fordwich and other sites in Britain to try and uncover more information about these ancient humans living there. Well, secretly, as you probably can imagine, the archaeologists are hoping to discover skeletal remains of an individual that used to live there all that time ago. Like, long, long ago, Homo Heidelbergensis in Britain. That would be amazing. So we can only hope that we will find remains or more pieces of the puzzle so we can broaden our understanding of life in the Acheulean period. But before I end the video, I would like to remind you of the link in the description down below and use the special discount code CyberGhostVPN only for my channel users to protect your data. It's a 45-day money-back guarantee and 24/7 customer support, so everything is risk-free. If you enjoyed watching, then don't forget to give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you'd like to see more of these kind of videos, and click that bell icon if you want to be notified whenever I upload. And if you haven't seen my previous videos yet, then click the card in the upper right corner, or click a link in the description down below, or click a video in the end card. I cater to you. YouTube caters to you. Click a video. And I would like to say a massive thank you to all my patrons and my channel members and everyone supporting me. And if you enjoy my work and you want to support me, consider becoming a patron or a channel member. And with that said, I'm gonna end this video right here because I've got not much to add besides the fact that I like Doggerland and I want to talk more about it, but I'm unsure if you guys want me to talk about Doggerland more. Do you? Let me know in the comments down below. Bye, guys.